Subscribe to Film Companion for your film fix. Hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Vetri, in your film, Mr. Nai, about a harrowing film about police brutality, there's a character who says, the system is all powerful. We are only pawns. Today, it feels like the system's even more powerful. The conversation is so shrill. It's so polarized. How do artists who want to tell political stories function today? What are you all experiencing? Anyone?
I would say that my politics is my films. And on a personal level, my problem is to say the story that's more relevant today, because everything today is like, you know, we all are being stifled. So to pick up the right one, which is going to be of the most relevance and most, which has the most urgency to discuss, I think that's more important. And then making a film that has a political view, a strong view, means we are saying something that the system is not going to like. And it really needs to make a film of those kind. Like, it really needs a big support system to do it. You need an investor, you need actors or non-actors, someone to come in and pull this off so that we are able to deliver the film. It's a teamwork, and all of us are unhappy with this whole setup. Like, not just the people who want to make films out of the issues. The whole world is unhappy. We have some people voice it, some people don't. I feel that is why all this is happening. We are able to make films, and you guys are able to do this.
Dibakar, you said in an interview that you keep raising your voice and you make risk, you make calculation about how much personal risk you can take. Vetri, talk about that calculation when you make your films. Asuran is also, all your films deal with corruption, they deal with the privileged and the not privileged, they deal with caste. How do you make this calculation? How do you figure out ki I can say this, but this will be too much?
To understand the kind of films that I'm allowed to make, you need to understand the Tamil cinema scenario better. Because unlike any other film space, Tamil cinema has always been part of, it has been used as political tools. Yeah. Like for the past like 70, 80 years, yeah, it's been used as political tools. And there is a blessing as well as curse for Tamil filmmakers. You don't have parallel movement in Tamil. Whatever you do, you have to do it for the mainstream. So you dilute it to an extent, and then the Tamil mainstream viewers are forced to watch any kind of anything that is given to them. Like in terms of, there is no elite viewers, where you just make an art house film, a parallel movement, parallel film that is constrained to a limited viewers, and you have other means of getting back the investment. Everything has to go to the theatres. Like a theatre that runs the Rajinikanth film will have to accommodate another film that would in another place be called a parallel film or an art house film. So this is the background in which the Tamil films are being made, and Tamil filmmakers think through this only. And making political statements, especially vote politics political statements, is very, very prevalent in Tamil, and the audiences have a direct connect to this kind of like undertones or whatever. Like,
yeah. An actor who
might or might not, or whenever he feels like coming or whenever he does not feel like coming, wants to make a statement, and the audiences understand that as a a reference to his political entry or the political party that he's going to start. Like any actor who's been acting for 15 years successfully will have an idea of getting into politics, like vote politics. So his, whether he has it or not, his fans have it. So we, like, you know, we just live around that. And the Dravidian movement had got a very strong presence even today in Tamil Nadu because of the effective and efficient use of films as a means of taking their ideology. And that has given a lot of freedom for Tamil filmmakers, and the Tamil viewers are kind of broader. And on a personal level, for me, to start with, I have an actor like Dhanush who is going to back me. So I don't have issues with my investments.
Right.
And then the major challenge I had was with Asura, because it's not just a political film, it's a Dalit film, like where the protagonist is a Dalit and the protagonist is not a meek protagonist. He stands up for what he feels is right, and he brings down the upper caste people. This was the most challenging thing for me, because we had a lot of pre-production, and while we were shooting, we had a lot of like speculations. Like we were thinking on, we did not want to offend anyone, because we are stating facts and we want everyone to understand the film. And we wanted a Dalit to have a representation within the film, and then a non-Dalit to see that and feel what had happened in the past, like how their parents or their grandparents were responsible for whatever that had happened.
Mm.
And that was the major challenge that we had in doing. And so that was the reason we refrained from mentioning any specific caste. Of course, we set it up in a particular geographical space where there are certain castes are dominant, but we did not make any specific
you
references.
You don't spell it out.
Yeah, we did not make any specific references so that everybody felt responsible for what had happened to the protagonist and his family and whatever that happened. And of course, we had all historical references. Whatever that were shown in the film were incidents that really happened.
Mm.
So that was in the collective unconscious as well, like, and in the memory itself. Like, people had it in their memory when they watched the film, and then they took responsibility for it. And I think that was the reason behind the
massive success.
Yeah, mainstream success of the film.
Yeah.